If we have damaged class X capacitor, safety capacitor in any EMI circuit, what are the basic points to replace that capacitor? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received a comment from my viewer that he has a circuit that was using RIFA PME series safety capacitor. That is basically X2 capacitor. He mentioned in the comment that capacitor is installed in hard side, line and neutral. This capacitor cracked badly. How to replace it? There are some basic points that are to be considered. Class X1, X2, X3, Y1, Y2, Y3, whatsoever. Either it is class X or class Y. Class X capacitor is used in line and neutral. Class Y capacitor is connected between line and earthing point, neutral and earthing point. X1, X2, X3. These will depend on the voltage ratings and the circuit category. Most of the time, X2 capacitor is used. RIFA PME is X2 capacitor. So we will select in the same class. That is normally 275 volt to 310 volt range, because it is connected between line and neutral. At standard voltage, it will remain approximately silent. Until any abnormal noise will reach here, this tank circuit will create an oscillation and it will block that noise. Sometimes there is damper resistor in parallel to this capacitor, so that will dissipate all unwanted energy. So first point, select X2. The second is capacitance. If you see this capacitor, MKP62, this is manufacturer series name, and then 104K, this is capacitance and tolerance. As my viewer mentioned, 0.033 UF capacitor. Sometime the capacitor is mentioned in microfarad, sometime in nanofarad, and sometime there is coded format. If you have this capacitor, 0.033 microfarad multiply with 1000 to convert into nanofarad. So it is 33 nanofarad. Now 33 nanofarad multiply with 1000, 33,000 picofarad. Now number of zeros will be used as a code. 3 zeros, 3, 3, 3, and number of zeros. This is code now. We need this code. If we have coded capacitor, that time we will use this capacitor, or we will use this capacitor, or we will use this value. Any value available here will be used as a replacement. First point, classification. Second point, capacitance. Third point, tolerance. KM, 10% K. M plus minus 20%. If the original capacitor is 10%, we will select K. As here, 104K. Then climate category and passive flammability class. Climate category, minus 40 degree Celsius, 110 degree Celsius. It is working temperature. So we will select the same code. And 56, number of days. If this capacitor is operated at 40 degree temperature, 95 relative humidity, this capacitor can withstand for 56 days with that damp heat condition, high humidity and 40 degree Celsius working temperature. So it is number of days. Then B is test category and its safety grade. The next is insulation resistance. Normally 15,000 mega ohms, 12,000 mega ohms. We will check data sheet. If RIFA capacitor is using 12,000 mega ohms at rated voltage, If you are selecting this MKP62, it will produce 15,000 mega ohms. So we will select this one. First point, carefully select the same classification. We will not select X1 or X3 or Y grade capacitors. So we will use the same category, that is original capacitor. Second thing, capacitance. Third thing, tolerance. If you will use any other value capacitor than the rated capacitor, it will change the corner frequency of this tank circuit that may cause ringing in the circuit. Any other unmatched component may cause ringing or will allow to pass the noises. Then the tolerance. Tolerance must be matched properly. If it is not available, then we can compromise to selecting next higher level. Climate category, it is also a point, and insulation resistance. So these are the basic points that must be observed to select replacement for a safety capacitor. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.